let's try to analyze the convergence of the power method. Now, we can pick any version of the power method we want, because we know they all start pointing in the right direction eventually. And therefore, if we can prove that one of them starts pointing in the right direction and how fast that happens, then that automatically translates to how the other ones start pointing in that direction as well. So it's convenient to pick the version where we divide by the eigenvalue as if we know it up front. So how did this method work? Well, we were given an initial vector v0, some direction, and then we kept hitting that vector with matrix A and dividing by the eigenvalue. Now, in analyzing this, what we notice is that after the kth iteration, the vector that we have computed is actually equal to the original vector, which has been hit by the matrix A k times, but then scaled back k times by dividing by lambda 0. Okay. It became convenient to say, let's take our original vector v0 and let's view it in the basis formed by the eigenvectors of matrix A, so let's write it instead as x times some vector y. Okay? Now what does that mean? That means that our vector v0 is replaced by x times y. But then if you think back about how we developed the power method, really what happens is that a to the kth power times x is the same as lambda to the kth power, x times lambda to the kth power. Now, this alternatively can be written as a linear combination of the eigenvectors of x, or we can write it in matrix form as follows, where we have taken this 1 over lambda 0 to the kth power and incorporated it into this diagonal matrix lambda. Okay, and each of these different ways of looking at it will tell us a little bit. All right, what this particular formulation tells us is that eventually all of these terms become arbitrarily small because lambda 0 is the eigenvalue largest in magnitude, which means that we expect to eventually point in the direction of psi 0 times x0. In other words, in the direction of x0, except the vector that we'll compute will be scaled by the coefficient, the first coefficient of our vector y. So this now allows us to see how fast we actually converge to that. Okay. We can take our vector vk and say, okay, eventually we know it's going to point in that direction. That's the same as taking this expression and subtracting off psi 0 times x0. It's the same as taking this term away right here. And if you think about it carefully, it's the same as taking this diagonal matrix and replacing this 1 by a 0. Now we can look at what happens to the length of this difference. We'd like for that length of the difference, we'd like for the norm of the difference to go to 0. And let's pick a norm. We'll take the 2 norm. If we looked at the 2 norm of this, that would have to be equal to the 2 norm of this, which would have to be equal to the 2 norm of this, and therefore equal to the 2 norm of this. And that's a little hard to write in there. Okay? And notice that we can then bound that by the 2 norm of this matrix times the 2 norm of this matrix times the 2 norm of that vector. And what does that mean? It means that we get is less than or equal to the 2 norm of x times the 2 norm of this diagonal matrix. But notice that the 2 norm of a diagonal matrix is equal to the absolute value of the largest entry on its diagonal, which happens to be this right here. So we get the absolute value of lambda 1 over lambda 0 to the kth power, and then times the two norm of vector.